My name is Emma Ferreira. I am a Dominican, Canadian, queer artist, actor, poet, storyteller, and my work explores what I am, who I am, and what I wish to see more of, which are perspectives that have been pushed to periphery, ones that are radical, truthful, and brave. And this is me reciting a little bit of my bio, and it feels very strange, but here we are. I would like to acknowledge the land that I'm on while recording this. I am in Tikaronto, which is the traditional territories of many nations, including the Mississaugas of the Credit, the Anishinaabe, the Chippewa, the Haudenosaunee, the Wendat peoples, and is now, was, still is, will forever be, home to many diverse First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people. I was asked to write and share a poem about my being Black in Canada, my relationship to Black heritage in Canada, for the Emancipation Day event. And I really loved writing this piece, and I'm really excited to share it with you. There's a lot of love and a lot of anger. There's anger in the fact that I only learned what Emancipation Day was for this country when I was 18. There's anger in the fact that that's Winnie. There's anger in the fact that in school I learned about les Autochtones and the discovery of Nouvelle-France, but I did not learn about the past, present, and continued genocide of our Indigenous brothers, sisters, and siblings, or the fact that there were enslaved Africans brought to this country, the fact that slavery existed in this country for 200 years before we claimed to be a safe haven for Black people, the fact that the term safe haven is used to discredit, to gaslight, and to deflect against the atrocities that happened to Black and Indigenous bodies on this land for years. The fact that even after enslaved people were free, that they would have to commit to years of indentured servitude to ensure their safety and their freedom in this country. So I'd also like to acknowledge my voice is a little bit raspy because the night before last I was protesting at 52 Division here in Tikaronto for the release of three Black Lives Matter protesters that were arrested during a peaceful art action. And we were there until 3 a.m. until all three were released. They were denied access to legal counsel for hours and hours. They were denied access to medication for hours and hours. We were not made aware about their safety or their whereabouts for hours upon hours. No one could give us answers. So I just find it interesting in talking about Emancipation Day, in celebrating it, commemorating it, sharing art around it, creating art around it in its historical context, that the night before last I was protesting for the freedom and release of three Black Canadians who were protesting against violence, oppression, and genocide. So with all of that, I would like to share this with you. I went camping in Algonquin and I felt really Black, because in the absence of excess, I felt the lack of access to this quintessential Canadian experience, to nature, to know-how, to true silence. I was kindly surprised by the kindness of onlookers and forever unsurprised by the unabashed confusion of others, having to temper this gut feeling of unwelcome, of trespassing, all these ways of being unlearned and learned again, alive but not awake to, alive with misunderstanding of the way they see me because of the way they look at me. Black heritage in Canada is unfamiliar to me. My Black heritage exists away from me. Your immigration policies made it almost necessary to leave my Blackness alone. No anecdotes in my history books reflecting my family tree. My Black found family thrives here against all odds. All this magical melanin pressed against the skylights, but my Black blood, mixed by mestizo, disappeared from our remembering like the ancestors on the slave ships that docked at the port where I grew up. My Black blood tricked into believing that we do not need this liberation, that we will be free just like the white man if we only kick out enough Haitians, acting like it has everything to do with pride and nothing to do with heavy imperial sedation. Oh, unholy American intervention. I want Black lives to matter to the Black and brainwashed too. Ancestors fleeting. ancestors fleeing, ancestors freeing, ancestors teeming with blood on their hands. First generation ancestor I am of my Black heritage in Canada, rooted in observation, rooted in discovery, rooted in preservation, continuation and meditation, rooted in all that has been denied me, given to me, allowed for me, and all of my palatability, all of the rooms I've been invited into, only to realize I am the only me they know how to see. Alone, having to fight demons that they don't know they carry, you can only get so far. My white friends often remind me of how not racist they are, as if my acceptance is a journey through a passage that begins and ends with me. The brownest shade in many collections of trust, I only know all that I don't, but when the smell of plantains drifts through that open window, it drags my body back across oceans, back to where, you know, the time moves slow. And the air is thick. The memory is pure as snow. But the plátanos, they always go quick. So I'm dragged back down into the belly of this multicultural yet culturally suppressant, so culturally rebellious yet one culture dominates beast I call home to wage wars. Never wanting to forget where I come from, but wanting, mama, to level the score. I've never promised to be a truth teller. I've only been her before. Our bodies are the same, but hers is just a little bit more ingrained in the way, in the culture, in the language. A truth teller whose womanhood was instead nurtured by su patria, su tierra, su sangre. My Black heritage, rooted in the observation of all that has been asked for and all who've fallen upon deaf ears, it bears no repeating, and yet it must be every time that we are here and allowed and alive, that enforcement will overshadow protection every single time, that we are here and allowed and alive, that this land you stole so you can say the true north strong and free, that we are here and allowed and alive. That my non-access I feel to being quintessentially Canadian is not a mistake, but is rooted in the fact that my people were enslaved here too, that we are here and allowed and alive. I am my ancestors' wildest dream and greatest nightmare. I walk this lineage of opposing sides like crossing privatized beach lines, thinking this is theirs and that is mine. Created by love. A love building bridges, a love that is despised while I am exoticized. I am the colonizer and the colonized. I wish to kill the voices of the ancestors in my mind that ask me to live in the absence of the me they would deny, and instead use my mouth as a megaphone for all these tias that live inside that wish to scream about liberation and dancing, inhaling and exhaling. Gracias. My Black in Canada is to crack the veneer of this false mosaic and all its forced niceties, to liberate my mind and march, tweet, sit, stand, walk, run, and abolish alongside all those who you, yes, you, Canada, have left behind. Thank you.